Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1968, Funnel Charts. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, yet another new feature that just came out in February 2016 for Office 365 is the Funnel Charts. There were all kinds of hacks to do these in the past, but now it's just built in. So here's how we do it. A list of categories, a list of values of those categories, select that data, go to the Insert tab, and then right here, underneath the waterfall or stock chart, they've added funnel charts. Look at that. How easy is that? So now let's talk about a few things here. First off, it starts off with this really dark blue, and of course, to change the colors, we're going to use the paintbrush, go to color, where they offer a lot of other really dark colors. I guess that one there will allow the text to show up. What if we want to vary the colors by point, right? That seems really obvious. Well, if you go to the Format tab and choose Series 1, right here, this is the fill area where they normally would have that checkbox for vary colors by point. No, you're more than welcome to use a pattern fill or a gradient fill or a solid fill, but there is apparently, at this time, no way to vary colors by point. That is one of the things these brand new charts, there's a few of them that were introduced in Excel 2016. They just don't have all of the functionality that we used to have in the old version of Excel. This last item down here that doesn't have the labels, is there some way to have those labels appear to the left or to the right? No, there's just not. You know, the only settings I can find that are kind of interesting is the gap width. Right now it's by default at a 6% gap. You can change that if you wanted the funnel to have bigger gaps. Boy, rather than having that, I would have much rather had a way to change the color of each point. But here we are. To change the labels, to make the labels more easy to read, choose that data in the cells, Control 1, and we'll use a thousand separator. Click OK. All right, great. Now I have commas, but I've lost that label. It's even worse. Let's do Control 1 and go to Custom, and I will show it in tenths of millions. So comma, comma. The first comma says show it in thousands. Second comma says show it in millions. Put an M there after it in quotes, and we still don't get anything for that last label. Oh well, I guess you can grab a pen and draw it in, or a pencil, or you know. Whatever, I don't know. It's crazy that we just don't have as much control here. But if you've needed to create funnel charts, here it is in Office 365. Again, you have to be an Office Insider or the first release program, and you'll have access to this new chart. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.